Johnson at a star-studded fundraiser for Caddies for Cure. I'm here with Christy Peterson, the Vice President of Caddies for Cure, along with mainstream media reporter David McGinnis. And Christy, it's got to be very exciting and rewarding to see an event like this come together with so many great bowlers and great celebrities here tonight.
It sure is. It's really a testament to a lot of volunteers, a lot of support, and we are able to pull off a fabulous event and raise a lot of money for some causes close to our hearts.
Now, Caddies for Cure has done an incredible job raising money and serving people. Really a great nonprofit in medical research and helping families. Talk a little bit more about your organization.
Sure. Caddies for Cure, we were founded in 2002, total grassroots. Two friends wanted to make a difference in their community. Ryan, his wife, was recently diagnosed with MS, and his friend Justin, they had lost a child to a congenital heart defect at Randall Children's Hospital. They formed this organization, and through the years we've grown it. What's really unique, we're 100% volunteer. Nobody is paid, 100% volunteer staff. This past week, our staff has worked around the clock, 60, 80 hours a week, and everyone does it out of the goodness of their heart. Total volunteer. We want to make a difference in the community. Our main two causes are the National Multiple Sclerosis Society, our Portland chapter, and Randall Children's Hospital. We also do other little things in the community. We try to, you know, build a junior caddy golf program and influence youth. We're really about family and children and giving what you can, whether it's your time, your talent, or your resources.
I will turn it over to mainstream media reporter David McGinnis. David, what kind of questions do you have for us?
Well, what brought you here?
What brought me to Caddies for Cure? Marcy was a dear friend of mine, is a dear friend of mine, and, you know, here was a chance I could do something to that's bigger than myself to make a difference. You know, we all have this capability to give of our talents. We have God-given talents, and I really believe we're meant to share them. So you find what you're good at, and you share it, and make a difference in the world.
And where are you born and raised?
I was born and raised in Minneapolis, Minnesota.
And how long have you been living here?
Gosh, since 1999, so longer than I ever imagined.
And you hope to stay here forever?
That's a hard question to answer. A year at a time.
Yeah.
That's still home.
Yes. And how long have you been a part of this?
I've been a part of Caddies for Cure since probably the fall of 2005. We really exploded Caddies for Cure in 2006 and made it a two-day event. This is the first year it's been a three-day event. And I came on board in that year, in 2005, to plan for 2006 and turn it into a two-day event. A gala night where we really do the, you know, big auction and everything, and then a golf tournament the next day. The golf tournament has always been here. The big gala night is new.
And what do you think of Oregon? What do you like about it?
What I like, well, you know, it's beautiful when it's sunny. You know, it's a nice community.
And
you know,
Minnesota is similar to Oregon.
There's similarities, yeah.
Yeah, because it's rainy up there.
It's not that rainy. It's cold. It gets snow, but
yeah.
It's a drier climate than here.
Oh, yes, it's flat.
Yeah, yeah. Lots of lakes.
What part of Minnesota are you from?
The Twin Cities.
Ah.
Yeah.
Twin Cities.
Yeah, it's really
nice. It was nice talking to you.
Yeah, you too. Thank you.
And one final question.
Sure.
Christy, well, this will be partly edited. But mainstream media has a very giving community and a lot of followers. So how can someone get involved in your organization if they would like?
Yeah, I mean, we're always, you know, recruiting for volunteers. We don't have an immediate need coming up in the next couple months, but we will in the future. Through our website, caddies4cure.com. And, I mean, we'll always accept donations. You know, that never ends. And throughout the year, we'll do online auctions of fabulous memorabilia experiences that people can bid on. And obviously, around this time of year next year, we'll be needing a whole bunch of volunteers to put on another awesome event.
Thank you, Jesse.
Thank you. Thank you, guys.